हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट सेलियंट फीचर ऑफ आवर इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन व्हिच सेज दैट इन इंडिया द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया प्रोवाइड्स फॉर सेटिंग अप ऑफ एन इंडिपेंडेंट जुडिशरी ऑल्दो इन आवर इंडिया द जजेस ऑफ सुप्रीम कोर्ट एंड हाई कोर्ट्स आर अपॉइंटेड बाय द सेंट्रल एग्जीक्यूटिव बट वंस द जजेस ऑफ सुप्रीम कोर्ट एंड हाई कोर्ट्स आर अपॉइंटेड देन दे आर नो मोर कंट्रोल्ड बाय एनी अथॉरिटी इंक्लूडिंग the central executive authority. The constitution of India secured to the judges the tenure of their service and they cannot be removed before the expiry of their tenure. Yes, they can be removed by the impeachment process which is given under the constitution of India itself. It has been stated in article number 124. So it is also very important to tell you students that in our India, no single judge of either Supreme Court or High Court has been impeached so far. Their salary and allowances, once determined by the Union Parliament, cannot be diminished to their disadvantage during the tenure of their service. So it is also one of the important privilege which is given to the judges of High Court and Supreme Court that their salary cannot be reduced during the tenure of their service, which provide them the sense of independent judiciary. This provision has been given in article number 125 of Indian Constitution. Apart from this, the High Court and Supreme Court judges vested with the power of judicial review. That means they can examine the constitutional validity of a law which is made by the parliament or which is made by the state legislature. A law which is declared as unconstitutional either by the High Court or Supreme Court becomes void and inoperative. This power of judicial review is regarded as integral part of Indian Constitution, which is constituting part of its basic structure. It has been held in the case of Minerva Mills Limited versus Union of India, as well as in Keshavanand Bharati versus State of Kerala. These judgments are the landmark judgments in our India. So what is stated in these judgments? Let us study. In Minerva Mills Limited versus Union of India, AIR 1980, Supreme Court 1789, as well as in Keshavanand Bharati versus State of Kerala, AIR 1973, Supreme Court 1461, the power of judicial review, which is vested in the High Court under Article 226 and in the Supreme Court under Article 32, has been held to be an integral and essential part of Indian Constitution. Constituting part of its basic structure, they regarded the power of the court as the part of basic structure of Constitution, which ordinarily can never be ousted or excluded from the Indian Constitution, either by the Parliament or by the state legislature. The next salient feature of our Indian Constitution is that there is the concept of adult suffrage. What is the meaning of suffrage? Suffrage means right of voting. In our Constitution of India, every citizen, irrespective of their caste, race, religion, sex, literacy, wealth, every citizen of India who is not less than 18 years of age has a right to vote. And by exercising this right of vote, they can elect representative to the legislature, both at the central as well as state level. And while giving this right of vote, there is not any discrimination of any caste, race, religion, sex, literacy, wealth, and so on. In the beginning, this voting right was given to the citizens of 21 years or more than 21 years. But this voting age was reduced to 18 years from 21 years in the year 1989 by way of 61st Constitutional Amendment Act of 1988. So this is the 13th salient feature of Indian constitution in which adult suffrage has been provided. The 14th salient feature of Indian constitution is that in our India, there is a concept of single citizenship. The Indian constitution provides for a single citizenship, and that is for the whole of India. In India, there is no concept of separate citizenship of the state. Every Indian in India is the citizen of India. A person from the Punjab state is a citizen of India. A person of the state of Maharashtra is also a citizen of India. There is only one citizenship, and that citizenship is given for India. No concept of state citizenship has been provided in our Constitution of India. So this is something about this lecture. For the next salient feature, be in contact with me and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.